So let's get the archer first. Let's get Ambrosia and Elixir. Where's the other archer? Here.
Greetings, guys and girls and fellow gamers. My name is Games Who Kicks In. Welcome back to Conan Exiles. In the last episode, we found the teacher of Set, and we got this little beauty going. Now, between Mitra and Set, we're going to have a very good combo going here, because Mitra gives us Healing Ambrosia, while Set gives us Antidotes to Poison. So between the two, we should be able to very soon, not in this episode, but we should be very soon be able to go into the spider cave and solo those sons of bitches, because all they really do is give you poison. And if you can cure that and you can beat the crap out of them, you're doing absolutely fine. But we're gonna have to test that, obviously. First of all, we're gonna have to farm some humans today. We're gonna have to go and get through all those camps you see there in the background and everything and just smash them and kill them to get basically what we need for making antidote, because we need to rip out their hearts. That's how it works. So I can't wait. This is gonna be exciting. We're also gonna be looking at making more steel stuff. Hopefully we're gonna level up. We're gonna work a little bit on the house if we have to wait for things to finish crafting. And we gotta mix it up a little bit. It's very hard to predict exactly what we're gonna do because some things just take a very long time. Either way, I really hope you're gonna enjoy the episode and you're gonna have a good time. If you do, remember to kick that like button in the balls to support the channel and the series. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. So let's get started. Since we last seen each other in the last episode, which was for me probably about a half an hour ago, for you a day, I made several things. I made my steel pick, my steel hatchet, I learned medium harness and medium boots. As soon as we level up again, I will learn the rest of the armor, because now we're gonna have to focus on armor. But my main target is at level 36 to unlock this son of a bitch, this Chimerian battle axe, which is gonna be absolutely awesome. Well, hopefully. And then we're gonna get into heavy armor as well. So, explosive jazz is something I'm gonna look at 39 as well, because that allows us to start raiding people that are online, which we're not gonna do. I'm just saying that that's what we would be able to do, because you need that to get past the stone walls, basically. Now, I also made a new weapon, a Stygian spear, which seems to be just about the same strength as the other spear, except it looks more badass. Look at this baby. It just looks absolutely fantastic. Look at this. Oh, this is awesome. This is really fantastic. I'm really loving it. And she does something here, which is, oh, this is dodging, is it? Okay, I never knew what the right click was for. Oh, okay, so you right click and then left click. Oh, wow, I didn't know that. Does she do that with all the weapons? Oh, we have to try that out. Anyway, that's not important. I just wanted to show you what we have done so far. And steel is such a pain to make, by the way. It takes steel fire, which you make from brimstone, and tar. Tar is a side product you get from making hide. So basically everything starts chaining together. And you're gonna have to get a little factory going where you constantly make hide to get tar. Then you constantly have to go to the cauldron to burn the tar into steel fire with the brimstone. And then you can use the steel fire, one steel fire and five iron to make one steel. Very, very long. It takes very long. So this took 200 iron. Here, these two, because they took 20 steel each. Anyway, I just thought I'd let you know this in case you haven't been there yet, or you don't even play the game yet, that you know exactly how this works. So let's get going. We're gonna have a lot of people to kill and take their hearts out. Yeah, sorry, I forgot actually to record part of it, and then the other part I got panicked. So what basically happened is I went up there and I placed my archer, and he didn't do anything. I pulled in the melee fighters and he was just standing there watching me fight. And we killed a couple of guys, we killed most of them actually. And I'm just making antidotes, as you can see here, which is absolutely fantastic. So we have now, look at that, nice, 7 antidotes, 17 antidotes. And they will cure poison, which is very good, because if you have crippling poison on you, that's exactly what you need. So we're gonna leave them in here, we don't really need to take them out, we can just leave them there. And, oh, whoops, something just happened. One of my hearts disappeared. Very good. Anyway, I have some ambrosia, I have some aloe extract. We're gonna go back there because there is a blacksmith, and I wanna try out what blacksmiths do in our blacksmith bench. And if the blacksmith is up there all the time, well, what we're gonna do is we're going to go up there a few times and just eradicate them. I'm also making the steel sword in the moment, which is finished. It's duplication book. One of them is actually fake, so I'm gonna have to relog. And then we're gonna leave in the morning, and we're gonna cut these sons of bitches up, and we're gonna take their hearts out, and we're gonna tame that
whatchamacallit, that blacksmith. I'm gonna have to actually make a truncheon as well. And we'll see if we can actually take him with us. That would be pretty awesome. Let's go and see if the blacksmith is still there. Now with this sword I should be having a much easier time than with that silly spike. We're gonna clear these guys out. There you go. Done. And we're gonna have an archer coming in here hot. So what we're gonna do is we're going to go in. We're going to pull the melee guys. Nobody here, okay. And the blacksmith is all the way in the back. So we're going to... There we go. Yeah, we can probably take him out. Okay, come on, shoot. Nice. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, don't care. Oh, nice. Most of them are still... There's the blacksmith. Most of them are still dead, which is great. Oh, balls, another archer. So let's get the archer first. Let's get Ambrosia and Elixir. Where's the other archer? Here. And did I kill the blacksmith now? Balls. I think I did. Balls, balls, balls. I killed the blacksmith. No, there he is. Okay, so. Let's heal. Is he blacksmith? Oh, he's an armorer. Okay, let him heal up a little bit. Okay, let him heal up a little bit more because he's on level 1. Nice. Please tell me he's passed out. Damn it, he's dead! I swear I hate this game for that. Force me to make a truncheon to knock people out only for... The bane of my life. Okay, let's see what you have in here. Well, you know what? I take your arrows and I think we're gonna drop all that just to be douchebags about it. So there we go. Actually, I'm gonna keep all of that. Why not? I have the room. Oh man, that is so annoying. Can we jump down there into the water? No, it looks pretty shallow. Actually, there it looks pretty deep. Okay, let's try it. We're probably gonna die. Oh, we made it. Nice. I like it. Woo! Okay, so next time we have to find a bigger blacksmith or armorer, whatever. Holy balls. That was good though. It was good though. So let's see what our thrall is doing, if our thrall is tamed by now. And I don't know when this guy is gonna be respawning or if he's respawning at all today. So what we're going to do is there's an area I want to have a look at, which the guys were talking about, and this is over here. So north of the city. Now, I don't know how we best get there, but I assume we can walk around here and hopefully get up here somewhere to get close to the city and see what it's about. I want to get into this area here, but maybe we have to run through the cities or something. I don't know. We will have to have a look. I have no idea. It's like when we went to the teachers. I go the most awkward way, probably the first, because it looks like it makes sense. And we want to have a look at the city as well if we can, of course. So let's have a look at the thrall first, and he's done. Excellent. So he's not coming with me because they're absolutely useless. I'm gonna put him in my base in case somebody attacks. There we go. We're gonna put you here. Nice. And now we have two. We have a male and a female, and these guys are fighters, and anybody coming in here uninvited is gonna get the crap kicked out of them because they're both level 2, so if they don't expect them to be there, they're definitely gonna lose. Okay, so now I'm also taking the Ankh of Mitra with me, and that is because this gives me healing items, so I want to make sure that between... Oh, I can actually have both equipped at the same time? That is awesome! That is so cool! So we can both like... Ha! That is pretty boss. I like that. Oh, nice. Okay, so let's go and see what we're gonna get. I hope we're not gonna die. I don't want to lose everything again, but I also need to level up, and there's certain things in the area which I was told we could beat, but we'll see how tough they are. While we're on the way over to the north, we have to go past here anyway. Let's see if we can pull a couple of these guys around corners and beat them senseless. That would be pretty good. I mean, they have big pillars we could walk around and see if they can work as a line of sight thing. I mean, it would definitely be really interesting. Let's see, a little closer. There we go. Look at that. Sniper. There, one is down. Nice. We're gonna play this for a little bit and see how far we get. Nice. Oh, balls. One of them is okay to hit, two is not. Okay, let's walk a bit higher. There we go. Nice. Okay, next hit should be dead. Oh, no. One more. Okay. Nice. Okay, now to these guys. There we go, nice. Wonder if we can just run in and get him. Okay, let's just do it. Come on. There we go. Let's run. Go. There, he's dead. Alright, so that's a couple of corpses for us to deal with. That's okay. Interesting. Okay, let's see if we can kill him. Let's see if we can destroy that. Oh, there's four of them. Here you go, a little bit of health. Come on, die. Excellent. Okay. We have some regen going on. Very nice, I like it. Oh, somebody's shooting me in the butt. Oh, look at that. Look at them stand here. There we go. Again. Regen. Get the archer. Get the archer. Come on. Nice. Get the fighter. Oh, man. We're going to slaughter our way through there. Nice. Okay, so we got them. Who's shooting at me? Oh, there's an archer on the far side. Okay, I can live with that. Come on. Oh, sandstorm balls. Come on. Okay, we're gonna have to skedaddle. There's a sandstorm in there. Why is it only in there? Is that corruption or something? No, it's not. Okay, we're gonna have to clear out the archer on the other side as well. I hope they haven't respawned yet, because sometimes they respawn like nearly immediately, which is such a pain in the ass. So this guy here, let's see if we can destroy the palisade. Okay, my sword is broken. I can't repair it because we have no iron bars, so let's take the other broadsword I brought with me. Let's go around and kill him. Nice. Okay, let's go over to the archer. Where is he? Here. Nice. Oh, look at that. Nice. Cleared them all out, baby. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Oh man, we are going into the temple, guys. We are going into the temple. Probably another couple of archers. This is what it's all about. Okay, let's go. Any more archers? Yeah.
Your heart will be eaten.
Okay, here's the archer. Come on, die, archer. Yes, archer is dead. Okay, skedaddle, skedaddle. Tactical retreat. It's only tactical retreat. We're going around the corners here. Come on, follow me, guys.
I will feast upon you.
There we go. Okay. Let's do some regen. Let's see if we can spot the archer. There he is. Wow, four archers. Holy balls. Let's get a good aim at him. A little higher. Damn it. Did we get him? A little bit higher, come on. Okay, they're really hard to get, so what are we gonna do? I don't know, let me just heal up a little bit, and then let me have a think about it. Oh, okay. I think we're gonna have to run up and then around before these guys respawn. They already respawned, so we better get a skedaddle. Okay, let's regen. Let's go. YOLO. Run. No, run. Oh, shit. Okay. Out, get out. Nice. We're still alive. We're regenning. Oh, man. I saw the chest, guys. I'm out of here. I'm gonna have to team up with someone. That is gonna be awesome, guys. Wow. That was definitely something. I'm so glad we tried that. So we saw the chest. The chest is on the left and on the right, and there is a shitload of archers. So there's no way you can probably run in naked, just grab it. I mean, our armor is completely knackered. We're gonna need higher armor. We leveled up again, which is absolutely fantastic. So I can probably spend some points now on getting the higher level armor as well. So if we look at here, look at them, we can get a heavy pauldron, like, oh my god. But obviously, the more we get up on armor, oh shit. They respawned. Alright, okay, I'm gonna see you guys back at base probably, because we're gonna have to repair, and I'm not sure if we're gonna go all the way north. There's a lot of things which you can do, but they need more than one person, and for the next couple of episodes I'm gonna be by myself before I can team up again with somebody. So I think what we might do is we're gonna start looking at building and expanding the base a little bit and building more bench, blacksmith benches, that's what I was going to say, and expand our production range. I think that's exactly what we're gonna have to focus on. Alright, this is how much we can carry. If you look at, I used the steel pickaxe, and that is all I have on me. I could have probably left my armor at home. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1300. Was it? 4, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, 1260. Now my armor weighs 3, 8, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we could have actually had another 100 ironstone. Wow, that is really good. So I might actually go for another quick run up without armor and get another load, and that should give us then in total nearly 1,000 iron bars in our furnaces, which is really good. And while we burn that, we're gonna continue working on our base, and that is really good news because that means we can make a lot of steel. So I'm gonna have to also, oh yeah, we're gonna have to get brimstone. That's actually what we're gonna do. We're gonna build in the next episode. So we're gonna have to go up to the crocodile cave behind my base. We're gonna have to get a lot of brimstone, and we're also gonna have to get a lot of bark so we can burn more hide to get more tar. Because tar and brimstone give fire steel, and you need to burn hide to make leather to get the byproduct of tar. Balls, don't you attack me now. I have nothing on me, you little bald bastard. Now, what does that do in damage? Does it actually have a damage value? 38. That's not too bad. We could kill him with that. I'm pretty sure we could. But I don't want to waste a good steel pickaxe on that. I'd rather take my sword with me then as well. What the hell is that?
Know this, slave, that when the kings of lesser races come to pay us homage, they come along the river that winds through the heart of our lands. Their pleasure barges come, laden with tribute of gold and silver and sacrificial flesh, to pass between the sentinels, the gateway to our kingdom. As they pass into the shadows of the sentinels, the merriment stills, the supplicants tremble. Look upon our works, ye mighty, and despair.
That is pretty awesome. Is that the same speech we had in the beginning? I didn't know there was one of those things down here. Wow. Every now and then I got like on the right hand side when I was swimming across the water like E to interact, and I was like, what the hell is that talking about? Because I know you can pick up kelp, like these long stringy things, these long stringy kelps, you can click on them and you can pick them up, so I thought it was talking about them. That is cool! Nice, I like it. Now the good thing about our base is that when we continue building it, up here we don't need to worry about stone. Because nobody can really jump up into a base, so even if they destroy these things here, they can't really get in. Now, could eventually probably cause this could collapse, but it just means we don't have to have a high priority on getting these things sorted. Now, up here, I would like to make a little balcony, that's why there's a hole. But anyway, that's besides the point. I'm gonna start burning these guys. Oh, look at that, I still had... Oh, nice. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna put them in. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and these ones are for steel then, or for brick, so I only want to use 3 at a time. So I'm gonna kick that off, I'm gonna do a little wood grind now, and then I'm gonna go up, get some more iron, put it in, and then we shall just burn this all to hell. Actually, just to show you this, when you get bark, there's no point using a very expensive pickaxe. So if you look at this, when you get bark, you get 3 bark, or 7 bark, yeah? Now, I have a stone axe here, which is the one you can craft the easiest. You get less wood, but we're not after wood, look. And you got also bark. You got 10 bark even in this case, yeah? So the bark isn't really affected by this, which is absolutely awesome. So if you're after bark, just use a stone pickaxe. Don't even waste your good precious steel pickaxe. Now we're going to take a steel axe, simply because we want wood, and we get about 35 wood per hit every time we hit a tree with that. So that's definitely worth using your steel pickaxe for, because you don't want to be spent forever grinding for wood just to burn it if you can get it in a much shorter time just using a better axe. So I'm off to my second run. I'm literally, everything is empty, no armor on me, nothing. We can hold a maximum number of ironstone now. Let's see how much that actually is. Just ate a little bit. We can manage to do exactly one run and we should be okay. And then it should be nightfall as well. Anyway, I'm gonna leave this episode here. In the next episode, we are going to focus more on building, and because I'm gonna have to see, probably have to wait until Friday night to meet up with people and see what they're doing, because everybody's in the US, and it's a pain in the neck for me, because I'm gonna have to do it during the night, which I can't do because I have to work on the next stage during the week, so that's why it has to be Friday or Saturday, but hopefully we're gonna get to meet up with the guys then in a couple of days. Until then, I'm gonna have to make single-player episodes on the multiplayer server, unless we get lucky and someone is online, but hey-ho, we never know what happens. We're gonna continue building some stuff, and hopefully it's gonna be great, and we're gonna be expanding our mass production area as well. I hope you had a good time, and if you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. I'll see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. All right, so that should be burning very nicely. We got 1860 stone we were able to carry. So we're gonna put another 100 wood in each, and that should be enough. Come on. There you go. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's another 700, 700, so 350, so 420 in each of them. That's over 1,250 iron. Nice.